two deadly shootings in U.S. military bases in just a matter of 3 days. After a gunman opened fire at the Pearl Harbor Naval Shipyard in Hawaii, killing two civilian employees on Wednesday, another tragedy on U.S. soil. On Friday morning, a shooter killed at least three people and injured multiple others, including two enforcement officers at Naval Air Station Pensacola, a major U.S. Navy base in Florida. The gunman has been identified as a Saudi military member in training at the site. He was shot dead during an encounter with authorities in a classroom. The Pensacola base is known to host international students for flight training and other military-related jobs.
Walking through the crime scene was like being on the set of a movie. And as the mayor eloquently put, you just don't expect this to happen at home. This doesn't happen in Escambia County. It doesn't happen in Pensacola. It doesn't happen to our friends and neighbors who are members of the United States Navy. But it did, and it has.
Filipino Mike Ison, who works at this air station, was clearly shaken by the tragedy.
I think the whole task force of the police is here, man. I think it's really, really serious right now. They got the helicopter flying. I'm right here outside the gate of NAS. It's an active shooter at the gas station of NAS.
Eight people are currently being treated at this Baptist hospital behind me, and community members are urged to support through prayers. As of now, the Naval Air Station, which employs more than 16,000 military and 7,400 civilian personnel, is still on lockdown. Meanwhile, Florida Congressman Matt Gaetz said the shooting should be investigated as an act of terrorism. President Donald Trump said the King of Saudi Arabia called him to express his condolences. He added the Saudi King condemned the shooting and that the attack doesn't reflect the feelings of Saudi people towards Americans. Paul Garilao, ABS-CBN News, Pensacola, Florida.